Carrie Engel from Valley View Farms is here to answer your plant and gardening questions. She brought some really pretty shamrocks.
Yeah, so if St. Patrick's Day is sort of an unofficial start to spring, I think, for a lot of people, coming up next week, so we have some shamrocks, and they're just nice. They're easy to grow. They're actually grown from little corms, so they do produce sort of a bulb when they're finished here. Mm-hmm. They bloom most of the year. They kind of slow up a little bit in late summer and kind of go dormant and come back up a little bit later on.
Yeah, okay. I know a lot of people who are ready to do some planting.
Absolutely.
Let's just put it behind us, right?
I'm with you.
We've got several questions. This one, when should I trim my rose bushes?
The best time to prune them is really back around December when they are dormant. You know, now is kind of a tricky time because we go from these, whatever, 2 degrees up to about 40 in no time. Mm-hmm. So I'd wait until you start to see a little green and then maybe go ahead and cut them back.
Okay, good deal. When's the best time to start planting my vegetable garden?
In most years, I'd say now you could start planting peas, potatoes, and onions, but I don't think you get anywhere near any of that yet.
Right.
So just as the ground dries out a little bit, as it warms up a little bit, certainly a lot of those perennial plants can go out, and then the cold lovers like the onions and the peas. And maybe just a couple weeks away, you can start some of your broccoli, cabbage, cauliflower, those sorts of things. So it's not far away. We just have to get this white stuff off the ground, let things warm up
a
little bit.
We're so close. I can feel it, Carrie. Last question. I'm hoping to add some orange-colored flowers to my garden this spring. Any suggestions?
The first ones that would be out would be the orange pansies, and there are a lot of those available. And kind of think about it next year, maybe planting some orange daffodils in the fall, so they could be coming up, and some beautiful orange tulips. As you get into, there are now orange petunias, certainly marigolds, Gerber daisies. For shady spots, there are some beautiful orange begonias, so there really is a lot to choose from.
Good suggestions.
As an Oriole fan, there's always little orange in my garden.
Yes, yes. All right, and they will be playing soon.
That's right.
Spring training. All right, thanks so much. Nice seeing you as always.
And